This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. A hymn is a type of song, usually religious, specifically written for the purpose of adoration or prayer, and typically addressed to a deity or deities, or to a prominent figure or personification. The word hymn derives from Greek hymnos, hymnos, which means a song of praise. The singing of hymns is called hymnody. Collections of hymns are known as hymnals or hymn books. Hymns may or may not include instrumental accompaniment. Although most familiar to speakers of English in the context of Christian churches, hymns are also a fixture of other world religions, especially on the Indian subcontinent. Hymns also survive from antiquity, especially from Egyptian and Greek cultures. Some of the oldest surviving examples of notated music are hymns with Greek texts. Contents 1. Origins 2. Christian hymnody 21. Music and accompaniment 211. Western Church 212. Eastern Church 22. The development of Christian hymnody 221. American developments 23. Hymn meters 3. Sikh hymnody 4. See also 5. References 6. Further reading 7. External links. Origins. Ancient hymns include the Egyptian Great Hymn to the Aten, composed by Pharaoh Akhenaten, the Vedas, a collection of hymns in the tradition of Hinduism, and the Psalms, a collection of songs from Judaism. The Western tradition of hymnody begins with the Homeric hymns, a collection of ancient Greek hymns, the oldest of which were written in the 7th century BC, praising deities of the ancient Greek religions, surviving from the 3rd century BC as a collection of 6 literary hymns. Hymnoi by the Alexandrian poet Callimachus. Patristic writers began applying the term hymnos, or hymnus in Latin, to Christian songs of praise, and frequently used the word as a synonym for psalm. Christian hymnody originally modeled on the Psalms and other poetic passages commonly referred to as canticles in the scriptures. Christian hymns are generally directed as praise to the Christian God. Many refer to Jesus Christ either directly or indirectly. Since the earliest times, Christians have sung psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, both in private devotions and in corporate worship. Matthew chapter 26 verse 30, Mark chapter 14 verse 26, Acts chapter 16 verse 25, 1. Help, a mighty fortress description and, a mighty fortress is our God. Traditional Lutheran hymn, Hedge. Translation problems playing this file. See media. Help, a writer of hymns is known as a hymnist or hymnodist, and the practice of singing hymns is called hymnody. The same word is used for the collectivity of hymns belonging to a particular denomination or period, e.g. 19th century Methodist hymnody would mean the body of hymns written and or used by Methodists in the 19th century. A collection of hymns is called a hymnal or hymnary. These may or may not include music. A student of hymnody is called a hymnologist, and the scholarly study of hymns, hymnists and hymnody is hymnology. The music to which a hymn may be sung is a hymn tune in many evangelical churches. Traditional songs are classified as hymns, while more contemporary worship songs are not considered hymns. The reason for this distinction is unclear, but according to some it is due to the radical shift of style and devotional thinking that began with the Jesus movement and Jesus music. Music and accompaniment in ancient and medieval times, stringed instruments such as the harp, lyre and lute were used with psalms and hymns. Since there is a lack of musical notation in early writings, the actual musical forms in the early church can only be surmised. During the Middle Ages, a rich hymnody developed in the form of Gregorian chant or plainsong. This type was sung in unison, in one of 8 church modes, and most often by monastic choirs. While they were written originally in Latin, many have been translated. A familiar example is the 4th century of the Father's Heart Begotten, sung to the 11th century plainsong Divinum Mysterium. Western Church later hymnody in the Western Church introduced 4-part vocal harmony as the norm, adopting major and minor keys, and came to be led by organ and choir. It shares many elements with classical music today, except for choirs, more musically inclined congregations and a cappella congregations. Hymns are typically sung in unison. In some cases, complementary full settings for organ are also published. In others, organists and other accompanists are expected to transcribe the 4-part vocal score for their instrument of choice to illustrate Protestant usage. In the traditional services and liturgies of the Methodist churches, which are based upon Anglican practice, hymns are sung often accompanied by an organ during the processional to the altar, during the receiving of the Eucharist, during the recessional, and sometimes at other points during the service. These hymns can be found in a common book such as the United Methodist Hymnal. The doxology is also sung after the tithes and offerings are brought up to the altar. Contemporary Christian worship, as often found in evangelicalism and Pentecostalism, may include the use of contemporary worship music played with electric guitars and the drum kit, sharing many elements with rock music. Other groups of Christians have historically excluded instrumental accompaniment, citing the absence of instruments in worship by the Church in the first several centuries of its existence, and adhere to an unaccompanied a cappella congregational singing of hymns. These groups include the Brethren, often both open and exclusive, the Churches of Christ, Mennonites, Primitive Baptists, and certain Reformed churches, although during the last century or so, several of these, such as the Free Church of Scotland, have abandoned this stance. Eastern Church, Eastern Christianity. The Eastern Orthodox, Oriental Orthodox, and Eastern Catholic churches have a very rich and ancient hymnographical tradition. Eastern chant is almost always a cappella, and instrumental accompaniment is rare. The central form of chant in the Eastern Orthodoxy is Byzantine chant, which is used to chant all forms of liturgical worship. Exceptions include the Coptic Orthodox tradition, which makes use of the cymbals and the triangle musical instrument, the Indian Orthodox Malankara Orthodox Syrian Church, which makes use of the organ, and the Ethiopian Orthodox Tewahedo Church, which also uses drums, cymbals and other instruments on certain occasions. The development of Christian hymnody. Thomas Aquinas, in the introduction to his commentary on the Psalms, defined the Christian hymn thus: Hymnus est laus Dei cum cantico, canticum autem exultatio mentis de eternis habita, prorumpens in vosum. A hymn is the praise of God with song, a song is the exaltation of the mind dwelling on eternal things, bursting forth in the voice. The Protestant Reformation resulted in two conflicting attitudes towards hymns. One approach, the regulative principle of worship, favored by many Zwinglians, Calvinists and some radical reformers, considered anything that was not directly authorized by the Bible to be a novel and Catholic introduction to worship, which was to be rejected. All hymns that were not direct quotations from the Bible fell into this category. Such hymns were banned, along with any form of instrumental musical accompaniment, and organs were removed from churches. Instead of hymns, biblical Psalms were chanted, most often without accompaniment, to very basic melodies. This was known as exclusive psalmody. Examples of this may still be found in various places, including in some of the Presbyterian churches of Western Scotland. The other Reformation approach, the normative principle of worship, produced a burst of hymn writing and congregational singing. Martin Luther is notable not only as a reformer, but as the author of many hymns, including Ein Fest Berg ist unser Gott, A Mighty Fortress is Our God, which is sung today even by Catholics, and Gelibet seist du, Jesu Christ, Praise Be to You, Jesus Christ, for Christmas. Luther and his followers often used their hymns, or chorales, to teach tenets of the faith to worshippers. The first Protestant hymnal was published in Bohemia in 1532 by the Unitas Fratrum Count Zinzendorf. The Lutheran leader of the Moravian Church in the 18th century wrote some 2,000 hymns. The earlier English writers tended to paraphrase biblical texts, particularly Psalms. Isaac Watts followed this tradition, but is also credited as having written the first English hymn, which was not a direct paraphrase of Scripture. Watts, 1674-1748, whose father was an elder of a dissenter congregation, complained at age 16 that when allowed only Psalms to sing, the faithful could not even sing about their Lord, Christ Jesus. His father invited him to see what he could do about it. The result was Watts' first hymn, Behold the Glories of the Lamb, found in few hymnals today. The hymn has 8 stanzas in common meter and is based on Revelation chapter 5 verses 6, 8, 9, 10, 12, relying heavily on Scripture. Watts wrote metered texts based on New Testament passages that brought the Christian faith into the songs of the Church. Isaac Watts has been called the father of English hymnody, but Eric Routley sees him more as the liberator of English hymnody, because his hymns, and hymns like them, moved worshippers beyond singing only Old Testament psalms, inspiring congregations and revitalizing worship. Later writers took even more freedom, some even including allegory and metaphor in their texts. Charles Wesley's hymns spread Methodist theology, not only within Methodism, but in most Protestant churches. He developed a new focus, expressing one's personal feelings in the relationship with God, as well as the simple worship seen in older hymns. Wesley wrote, Where shall my wandering soul begin? How shall I all to heaven aspire? A slave redeemed from death and sin, a brand plucked from eternity. eternal fire, how shall I equal triumphs raise, or sing my great deliverer's praise? Battle Hymn of the Republic. The Battle Hymn of the Republic, performed by Frank C. Stanley, Elise Stevenson, and a mixed quartet in 1908. Problems playing this file. See Media Help. Wesley's contribution, along with the Second Great Awakening in America, led to a new style called gospel, and a new explosion of sacred music writing with Fanny Crosby, Lena Sandell, Philip Bliss, Ira D. Sankey, and others who produced testimonial music for revivals, camp meetings, and evangelistic crusades. The tune style or form is technically designated gospel songs, as distinct from hymns. Gospel songs generally include a refrain or chorus and usually, though not always, a faster tempo than the hymns. As examples of the distinction, Amazing Grace is a hymn, no refrain, but How Great Thou Art is a gospel song. During the 19th century, the gospel song genre spread rapidly in Protestantism and, to a lesser but still definite extent, in Roman Catholicism. The gospel song genre is unknown in the worship per se by Eastern Orthodox churches, which rely exclusively on traditional chants, a type of hymn. The Methodist revival of the 18th century created an explosion of hymn writing in Welsh, which continued into the first half of the 19th century. The most prominent names among Welsh hymn writers are William Williams Pantycelyn and Anne Griffiths. The second half of the 19th century witnessed an explosion of hymn tune composition and choir singing in Wales, along with the more classical sacred music of composers ranging from Mozart to Monteverdi. The Catholic Church continued to produce many popular hymns such as Lead, Kindly Light, Silent Night, O Sacrament Divine, and Faith of Our Fathers. Many churches today use contemporary worship music, which includes a range of styles often influenced by popular music. This often leads to some conflict between older and younger congregants. See contemporary worship. This is not new. The Christian pop music style began in the late 1960s and became very popular during the 1970s, as young hymnists sought ways in which to make the music of their religion relevant for their generation. This long tradition has resulted in a wide variety of hymns. Some modern churches include within hymnody the traditional hymn usually describing God, contemporary worship music often directed to God, and gospel music expressions of one's personal experience of God. This distinction is not perfectly clear, and purists remove the second two types from the classification as hymns. It is a matter of debate, even sometimes within a single congregation, often between revivalist and traditionalist movements. American developments. African Americans developed a rich hymnody from spirituals during times of slavery to the modern, lively black gospel style. The first influences of African American culture into hymns came from Slave Songs of the United States, a collection of slave hymns compiled by William Francis Allen, who had difficulty pinning them down from the oral tradition, and though he succeeded, he points out the awe-inspiring effect of the hymns when sung in by their originators. Hymn writing, composition, performance, and the publishing of Christian hymnals was prolific in the 19th century and was often linked to the abolitionist movement by many hymn writers. Surprisingly, Stephen Foster wrote a number of hymns that were used during church services during this era of publishing. Thomas Sims spread throughout churches a new idea of how to sing hymns, in which anyone could sing a hymn any way they felt led to. This idea was opposed by the views of Sims' colleagues, who felt it was like 500 different tunes roared out at the same time. William Billings, a singing school teacher, created the first tune book with only American-born compositions within his books. Billings did not put as much emphasis on common measure, which was the typical way hymns were sung, but he attempted to have a sufficiency in each measure. Boston's Handel and Haydn Society aimed at raising the level of church music in America, publishing their collection of church music. In the late 19th century, Ira D. Sankey and Dwight L. Moody developed the relatively new subcategory of gospel hymns. Hymn meter's main article, meter hymn. The meter indicates the number of syllables for the lines in each stanza of a hymn. This provides a means of marrying the hymn's text with an appropriate hymn tune for singing. In practice, many hymns conform to one of a relatively small number of meters. Syllable count and stress patterns. Care must be taken, however, to ensure that not only the meter of words and tune match, but also the stresses on the words in each line. Technically speaking, an iambic tune, for instance, cannot be used with words of, say, trochaic meter. The meter is often denoted by a row of figures besides the name of the tune, such as 878,787, which would inform the reader that each verse has six lines, and that the first line has eight syllables, the second has seven, the third line eight, etc. The meter can also be described by initials. LM indicates long meter, which is 8,800. 4,888 lines, each 8 syllables long, SM is short meter 6,686, CM is common meter 8,686, while DLM, DSM and DCM the D stands for double or similar to their respective single meters except that they have 8 lines in a verse instead of 4 also. If the number of syllables in one verse differ from another verse in the same hymn e.g., the hymn I Sing a Song of the Saints of God, the meter is called irregular Sikh hymnody. The Sikh Holy Book, the Guru Granth Sahib Ji Punjabi, Guru Granth Sahiba is a collection of hymns Shabad or Gurbani describing the qualities of God and why one should meditate on God's name. The Guru Granth Sahib is divided by their musical setting in different ragas into 1430 pages known as Angs Limbs in Sikh tradition. Guru Gobind Singh 1666-1708, the 10th Guru, after adding Guru Tegh Bahadur's Bani to the Adi Granth affirmed the sacred text. As his successor, elevating it to Guru Granth Sahib, the text remains the holy scripture of the Sikhs, regarded as the teachings of the 10 Gurus. The role of Guru Granth Sahib, as a source or guide of prayer, is pivotal in Sikh worship. See also Carol Chorale Contemporary Worship Music, Contemporary Catholic Liturgical Music, Doxology, Hymn Society in the United States and Canada, Hymn Society of Great Britain and Ireland, CAFI List of Chinese Hymn Books, List of English Language Hymnals by Denomination, List of Roman Catholic Hymns, Metric Psalter, Psalm, Sacred Harp. Shape Note Shabad Vedic Chant References. Carat Entry on Hymnos, Liddell and Scott, A Greek-English Lexicon, Oxford, Clarendon Press, 8th edition 1897, 1985 printing, p. 1849, Entry on Hymnus, Lewis and Short, A Latin Dictionary, Oxford, Clarendon Press, 1879, 1987 printing, p. 872. Carat Askew, McElrath, 1980, Sing with Understanding, An Introduction to Christian Hymnology, ISBN. Carat Routley and Richardson, 2005, 1979, A Panorama of Christian Hymnody, Chicago, GIA Publications, Inc. pp. Rabbit Books, P. Wren, Brian, Praying Twice, The Music and Words of Congregational Song, Louisville, Westminster, John Knox Press, 2000, ISBN 0-664-25670-8. External links. The links below are restricted to either material that is historical or resources that are non-denominational or inter-denominational. Denomination-specific resources are mentioned from the relevant denomination-specific articles. The Hymn Society in the United States and Canada. Hymn Jesus Music, Sacred Harp. Shape Notes. Spiritual Modern Genres. Contemporary Christian Music. Contemporary Worship Music. Gospel Music. Neues Geistliches Lied. Fusion Genres. Christian Alternative Rock. Christian Country Music. Christian Hardcore. Christian Hip Hop. Christian Metal. Christian Punk. Christian Rock. Christian Ska. Gospel Blues. Latin Christian Music. Progressive Southern Gospel. Southern Gospel. Traditional Black Gospel. Urban Contemporary Gospel Chant. VE Christian Liturgical Chant. Eastern Armenian. Byzantine. Coptic. Georgian. Obikad. Bulgarian. Greek. Kievan. Prostopini. Syrian. Xenomini. Western. Ambrosian. Anglican. Beneventan. Celtic. Gallican. Gelino. Gregorian. Mozarabic. Old Roman. Lists Anglican Church composers. Christian bands and artists by genre. Christian country artists. Christian dance, electronic, and techno artists. Christian hardcore bands. Christian metal artists. Christian performers of hip-hop and rap. Christian punk bands. Christian ska bands. Christian record labels. Christian vocal artists. Christian worship music artists. Gospel musicians. Related topics. Anglican church music. Christian media. Christian music festival. Christian music industry. Christianity. Church music. Contemporary Catholic Liturgical Music. Category Commons. Portal Authority Control. GND 4125676-1.